गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10। आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम वी आर हियर टू स्टार्ट आवर स्टडीज। बिफोर एग्जाम वी वेयर बिजी इन चैप्टर 12 ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। इन दिस ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री इफ वी गो बैक वी हैव सीन द इंट्रोडक्शन व्हाट इज ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स। देयर आर सर्टन लिमिट्स that the oxides of carbon means carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, metallic carbonates like sodium carbonate, potassium carbonate, any metallic carbonate and bicarbonate plus metallic cyanide, sodium cyanide, potassium cyanide or metallic carbides like calcium carbide, sodium carbides, these all are excluded. These are not the organic compounds, though they contain carbon, but they are not organic compounds. We had seen we can get organic compounds from plant, animal, coal, petroleum, by fermentation and wood. We had also seen the difference between organic and inorganic compounds. What are the applications? What are the uses of organic chemistry? We had seen that without organic compounds, we cannot proceed even a single step in our life. Here, we had seen unique nature of carbon atoms, that carbon can form long and very long chain. This may be straight chain, branch chain, or it may be closed chain or cyclic chain. We had also seen that carbon can form single, double or triple covalent bond. Two atoms of carbon will share one electron each, means it will form single covalent bond, and if there is a bonding between two carbon atoms, if there is a bonding of two electrons each, means four electrons, two pair of electrons, it will be double bond, double covalent bond, or if each carbon shares three electrons, it will be triple covalent bond. We had seen this. Now, what today we will start from here. What are the different types of organic compounds? First, we should know organic compound. Once again, I would like to remind you ki any organic compound will essentially contain carbon with addition of hydrogen. Some may contain carbon and hydrogen. Some organic compounds may contain carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Some may contain carbon, hydrogen and nitrogen, phosphorus, soda. So, these organic compounds are classified like hydrocarbons. The organic compounds have been classified as hydrocarbon. Now, from this hydrocarbon, their derivatives are, from this hydrocarbon, first of all, what is hydrocarbon? Hydrocarbon are the compounds which are made up of, that are made up of only carbon and hydrogen atoms. So, means hydrocarbon means compound made up of hydrogen and carbon and hydrogen only, nothing third one is there. And derivatives. What do you mean by derivatives? जो हम बनाते हैं, like दूध, दूध से हम दही बनाते हैं, we make curd from milk, तो curd is a derivative of milk, we prepare paneer, we prepare chhena, we prepare many types of sweets from milk, so these sweets, chhena, curd, butter, they are the derivatives of milk, likewise. Many compounds can be prepared from this hydrocarbon. So, the derivatives of hydrocarbons are alcohol, aldehyde, carboxylic acid, ethane, methane, so on. We will see one by one later on. These compounds may contain, these organic compounds means these hydrocarbons may contain any number of carbon, any number of hydrogen, sulfur, phosphorus, but there will be a systematic rule ki if it contains a fixed number of carbon, what will be its name? We will see it. See, so it may contain elements including hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen and halogens, as well as phosphorus, silicon or sulfur. See, here is, if you see hydrocarbons, they are of, first of all, they are of three types. One is your alkane, alkene, alkyne. What is the difference between alkane, alkene and alkyne? Okay, here this is carbon. It has four valence electron. This carbon has also four valence electron. If they share one electron each, now here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here is your hydrogen, 6, 7, 8. So this carbon has now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons. What about this one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, if it is 6, 7 and 8. What will be the formula? C, C2. What it will be? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. It is called ethane. Ethane, A-N-E, mind it. A-N-E. Likewise, if it is three carbons are there, all are having four valence electron. Now, after sharing, this has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then it will be hydrogen 6, 7, 8. For this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now it shares, then 6, it will be 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What will be the formula? 1, 2, 3, C, 3. What is the number of hydrogen atoms? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, this is called propane. Propane. So, all the carbon atoms are forming single covalent bond, such type of hydrocarbon in which the carbon atoms I am saying, mind my language, there should be the bonding, whether it is single, double or triple, it should be only between two carbon atoms. So, all the carbon atoms are forming single covalent bond, such type of hydrocarbons are called alkanes. Such type of hydrocarbons are called alkanes. Now, they are called alkanes. Its general formula is CnH2n plus 2. If you see here, where n is the number of carbon atoms. Here carbon atom is 2. Here will be 2n plus 2 means 2 2's up 4 plus 2 6. Here n is carbon atoms is 3. The 3 2's are 6 plus 2 8. Likewise butane. Butane it is C4H10. They all are called alkanes. You can see here on the next page, it is page number 187. There are some examples of alkanes. Then its formula is CnH2n plus 2. Now it is alkene, CnH2n. Here is carbon. It has 4 valence electrons. If it shares 2 electrons, what will be the number of electrons for this carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What will be about this one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Formula will be C2, 1, 2, 3, 4, C2H4. It will be called eighth. Here we were using A-N-E. Here we will use E-N-E. It is ethene. Likewise, here are three carbons. If it shares, they have 4 valence electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4. This carbon has 1, 2, 3, 4. This has 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, if it shares 2 electrons, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, it shares or combines with hydrogen. Now, duplet is formed. Octet is also formed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For this carbon, you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Octet is complete. What about this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here it will be 6, 1 hydrogen, 7, another hydrogen. It is 8. What will be the formula? 1, 2, 3. It will be C3. What will be number of hydrogen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hydrogen is 6. So, here you see C2H4, C3H6. Likewise, it will be C4H10. This is called propene. So, this is called alkene. So, the hydrogen carbon, where there is a double bond, it is called alkene. Its formula will be CnH2n. You can see here. These are the alkenes having formula CnH2n. They are ethene, propene, butene, pentene, hexene, and so on. Next one is your after alkene. It will be alkyne. Formula is what? CnH2n plus 2. In this alkyne, see, here is carbon. It has 4 valence electrons. This carbon has 4 valence electrons. If they combine together, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1 is your hydrogen. It is 8 for this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now it will be 8. What will be formula? C2H2. It is called acetylene. C2H2 is called acetylene. And we also call it IUPAC name is your ethyne. Here is 1, 2, 3, 4. They all have 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. This 1, 2, 3, 4. This carbon has 1, 2, 3, 4. If you see, if it shares one electron each, now here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What will be the number of carbon atoms? 1, 2, 3, 4. Means C4. What is hydrogen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you see here, number of carbon atoms is 4. It is 4 to the 8, 8 minus 2, 6. So, its general formula will be CnH2n minus 2. Here, one triple covalent bond is formed. One triple covalent bond is formed. So, the hydrocarbons in which there is a triple covalent bond between two carbon atoms, they are called alkynes. A-L-K-Y-N-E, alkynes. So, for single covalent bond, we use alkane. K-A-N-E. For double covalent bond, we use E-N-E. And for triple covalent bond, Y-N-E. So, this is for today. We will see the rest in the next class. Wish you all the best.